Over the past week, the U.S. has seen an average of at least 60,000 new cases of COVID-19 per day. According to a New York Times analysis, there are still 16 states seeing rising infections, while 28 others have figures plateauing, and 10 more states seeing declining numbers. With many critics calling for more drastic moves from the federal government, including a national mask mandate and even lockdowns, on Monday, President Donald Trump resisted going backwards.
It's important for all Americans to recognize that a permanent lockdown is not a viable path toward producing the result that you want, or certainly not a viable path forward, and would ultimately inflict more harm than it would prevent. In our current phase, we must focus on protecting those at highest risk while allowing younger and healthier Americans to resume work and school with careful precautions. Ideally, we want to open those schools. We want to open them. At the same time, we're placing an emphasis on continuing to drive down the mortality rate with improved care, treatment, and medical interventions.
Despite the U.S. still leading the world in COVID-19 cases, Trump defended how his administration has responded to the pandemic while continuing to blame China for the outbreak.
If you look, countries all over the world are exploding right now. People that you said were doing a wonderful job, so wonderful. But right now, take a look at the countries that are exploding. You have Italy back, you have Spain back, you have France back, you have Germany back. You have a lot of countries, and that's not to knock them. It is a very delicate, very contagious disease. It was released by China. It should never have been allowed to release.
Meanwhile, the country's top infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, once again chimed in on the strategy to reopen schools in the coming weeks. While he supports states' efforts to push through with in-person learning, primarily for the psychological and nutritional benefit for children, he also emphasized that safety comes first and that this strategy should only be implemented in areas with low infection rates.
The primary consideration should always be the safety, the health, and the welfare of the children, as well as the teachers, and the secondary effects for spreading with regard to the parents and other family members. If the infection rate is so low that there's very little chance of there being infection spread, then you should feel okay about doing it, but making sure that you do the things that are necessary to prevent spread.
As of Tuesday, the U.S. has reported more than 4.7 million cases of COVID-19, with more than 156,000 deaths.